Good evening, brothers and sisters in Christ. Welcome to our third night of meetings with Pastor James Colwire. I'm sure many of you are looking forward to tonight. Same that I am, although I wasn't exactly looking to lead, but looking forward to hearing Pastor James. And, you know, just as Jesus left the best wine to the last, we too will receive the best of what the Lord would want to download to us. Yeah, amen. The best is reserved to the end. Hallelujah. The past few nights of teachings have been very deep and eye-opening for all of us. Despite the hiccups and the internet interferences. In fact, the interruptions only highlight to us, you know, the possible intense times ahead of us as we seek to move forward spiritually. More than just good teachings that we have had the past three nights, it is, as I see it, three things. Firstly, it's a call of the Lord for the Church of Malaysia to repair breaches, as we have heard, so there is no room for the enemy, because the Lord himself wants to be a wall of fire around our nation, as it says in Zechariah 2 verse 5. And this is very much in line with the vision of MUFW. It's just basically reiterating that call for the ecclesia, and not just a call, but a very urgent call, right? For the Church of Malaysia to repair the breaches. Secondly, it's a call to build the tabernacle of the Lord, to host his presence in our nation, to fulfill the destiny of Malaysia to be an altar nation. For those of you who were at the morning prayer this morning at the firewall prayer altar, you would have heard Pastor James mentioning through the audio about the destiny of Malaysia as an altar nation, not just an altar nation, but a fire altar nation, okay? That will impact nations. Wow. So that's two things. The third thing I sense also as we listen to the teachings, just hearing the teachings is not good enough. It's a call. I sense it's a call for us to respond. You know, the teachings are not meant to just tickle our ears, but for us to do something about it, to commit ourselves to the cause of Christ. You know, as scriptures tell us, let him who has ears, let him hear. So tonight, that's what we want, to hear what the Lord is saying. In fact, the last few nights, the voice of the Lord has been booming and thundering to us. Are we hearing what the Lord is saying to us? So tonight we want to position ourselves to hear, and not just to hear, but to obey, to do what we know we ought to do. And so many of the things, areas that have been touched on by Pastor James, but one of the main things highlighted by him last night was regarding the truth of God that necessary to permeate the body of Christ. And he said something like, only the truth will remove the deception, the lies, the falsehood, the compromise, even false prophets, and so on and so forth. It is the truth that will set us free to be a church of holiness, of power and authority. And so he was encouraging us to embrace truth, to fight for the truth, to pray for the truth, especially in the body of Christ. What a calling! What an assignment! May we respond fully. Amen. So as we begin tonight, I just want, before we go into a time of worship, let us just commit this time to the Lord. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. Praise you, Jesus. Oh Lord, your ecclesia, represented by so many churches here tonight, welcome you. Welcome you, Holy Spirit, into our meeting tonight. Have your way amongst us. You are the Spirit of truth, and you will guide us into all truth. Reveal yourself to us, Lord, how we need you. Cause us to know you as your word is being unfolded to us. And empower us to do your will. Cause us to break through, even within ourselves, into the deeper realm that you are drawing us into. We ask for your special enabling and empowering by your Holy Spirit upon Pastor James tonight.
Yes.
For a spirit of liberty to minister your truth and grace. Indeed, Lord, we know that where your Spirit is, there is liberty. And so we speak liberty tonight.
Amen.
We speak liberty, therefore, from every encumbrances, every hindrances, and every wicked plans of the enemy. In Jesus' name, in Jesus' name. Let us enter into a time of worship as we usher in the presence of the Lord. Hallelujah. Over to you, Pastor Nixon.
Hallelujah. Shalom, everyone. Hello. It's an honor and privilege to come before God with song of praise to Him. Let's join together in singing and connect our hearts to glorify Jesus. Days of Elijah, a prophetic song. As we sing, we declare breakthrough and glory to our land and our lives. Behold, He comes, riding on the cloud, shining like the sun, and the trumpet call. Lift your voice, the year of Jubilee, another Zion's hill shall vision come. These are the days of Elijah, declaring the word of the Lord. And these are the days of your servant Moses, righteousness being restored. Though these are days of great trial, of famine and darkness and sorrow, still we are the voice in the desert, crying, prepare the way of the Lord. Behold, He comes, riding on the clouds, shining like the sun, at the trumpet call. Lift your voice, the year of Jubilee, now the Zion's hill salvation come. These are the days of Ezekiel, the dry bones becoming as flesh. And these are the days of your servant David, rebuilding a temple of praise. Oh, these are the days of the harvest, the fields are swathed in your world. And we are the laborers in your vineyard, declaring the word of the Lord. Behold, He comes, riding on the clouds, shining like the sun, and the trumpet call. Because the year of Jubilee, another Zion's hill salvation come. These are the days of Elijah, declaring the word of the ten claps. He shattered his of your servant Moses' righteousness being restored. Though these are days of great trial, famine and darkness and sore, still we are the voice in the desert, crying, prepare the way of the Lord. Behold, he comes, riding on the clouds, shining like the sun, and the trumpet call, lift your voice, the year of Jubilee. Another Zion's hill, salvation comes. And these are the days of Ezekiel, the dry bones becoming as clay. And these are the days of your servant David, rebuilding a temple of praise. Oh, these are the days of the harvest, that the fields are as white in your world. And we are the laborers in your vineyard, declaring the word of the Lord. Behold, he comes, riding on the clouds, shining like the sun, at the trumpet call, lift your voice, the year of Jubilee, another Zion's hill, salvation comes. Hallelujah, Jesus. We sing the next song, the goodness of God. His love never fails us. He said in Isaiah 43 verse 2, when you go through the waters, I will be with you, and through the rivers, they will not go over you. When you go through the fire, you will not be burned, and the flame will have no power over you. I love you, Lord. Oh, your mercy never fails me. All my days have been held in your hand. From the moment that I wake up until I laid my head, oh, I will sing of the goodness of God. And all my life you have been faithful. And all my life you have been so, so good. With every breath that I am able, oh, I will sing of the goodness of God. I love your voice. You have led me through the fire. In the darkest night, you are close like no other. I have known you as a father. I've known you as a friend. And I have lived in the goodness of God. All my faithful. All my life you have been so, so good. With every breath that I am able, oh, I will sing of the goodness of God. Your goodness is running after, it's running after me. Your goodness is running after, it's running after me. With my life laid down, I surrender now, I give you everything. Your goodness is running after, it's running after me. All my life. faithful. Thank you, Lord Jesus. And all my life you have been so, so good. Every breath that I am able, I will sing of the goodness of God. And all my life you have been faithful. All my life you have been so, so good. Every breath that I am able, I will sing of the goodness of God. I will sing of the goodness of God. All my life you have been faithful. All my life you have been so, so good. Every breath that I am able, I will sing of the goodness of God. God, you are so good. God, you're so good. I am saved in Jesus' name. Highly favored, anointed, filled with your power. For the glory of Jesus' name. Let's declare, I am blessed, I am God, I am healed, I am whole. I am saved in Jesus' name. Highly favored, anointed, filled with your power. For the glory of Jesus' name. Amazing love that welcomes me, the kindness of mercy that bought with blood wholeheartedly my soul undeserving. God, you're so good. Oh God, you're so good. God, you're so good. You're so good to me. the cross, edge to edge, and hour by hour. The dead are raised, the sinners say, the work of your power. God, you're so good. God, you're so good. Yes, you are Lord. God, you're so good. You're so good to me. Oh God, you're so good. Oh God, you're so good. Thank you, Jesus. God, you're so good. God, you're so good. You're so good to me. I am blessed. I am God, I am healed, I am whole, I am saved in Jesus' name. Highly favored, anointed, filled with your power, for the glory of Jesus' name. I am blessed, I am God, I am healed, I am whole, I am saved in Jesus' name. Highly favored, anointed, filled with your power, for the glory of Jesus' name. And should this life bring suffering, Lord, I will remember what Calvary has bought for me, both now and forever. You're so good, yes you are Lord. God, you're so good. God, you're so good. You're so good to me. Hallelujah, Jesus. God, you're so good. God, you're so good. God, you're so good. You're so good to me. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Lord, we bow our knees. Humble ourselves and pray. Lord, we see your face and humble ourselves and turn from our wicked ways. Yes, Lord. Father, reign your mercy. Forgive our sin. Father, in your mercy, come heal our land. Lord, heal our land. Father, heal our land. Hear our cry and turn our nation back to you. Lord, heal our land. Hear us, Lord, and heal our land. Forgive our sin and heal our broken land. Ridi boshada manush ete hidi alabu. Lord, we bow our knee, we humble ourselves, humble ourselves and pray. Lord, we see your face, humble ourselves and turn from our wicked ways. Father, in your mercy, oh Lord, forgive our sins. Father, in your mercy, come heal our land. Lord, heal our land. Father, heal our land. Hear our cry and turn our nation back. Our sin and heal our broken land. May the winds of the Holy Spirit, Lord, blow across our land, bringing revival. Shani Bode Hastai.
Let's continue with this other song, I Enter the Holy of Holies, Pastor Nixon. Because Pastor James is not in yet, yeah?
For your name is holy, Lord. I enter the holy of holies. I enter through the blood of the Lamb. I enter to worship you only. I enter to honor I am. I enter the Holy of Holies. I enter through the blood of the Lamb. I enter to worship you only. I enter to honor I am. Lord, I worship you. I worship you. Lord, I worship you. I worship you. For your name is holy. For your name is holy, holy, Lord. Ooh. Ooh. Shire nemo hoshalibo. Ridinias Shalamondo Shalidibo Shalamo Shadi and the Ridibo Shandi Hidi and the Hidi Aladabo Shini and the Labo Yalabo. Lord, I worship you. Holy, Lord. Shini and the Hini Mondo Shalana Bohu Shedi and the Debo Rata Hini Nimo Shayalana. Your name is holy. Your name is holy. Yakahana mohos ini mondorede ikini na mohos alana manduro debo. Your name is holy. Your name is holy.
We're going to pray now because Pastor James is having difficulties logging in. So together with one voice, we're going to just have this time to just pray. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Cora, let's unmute and begin to pray. Oh, Rihanna, the karma shake it.
Masun dolo, Rokoro,
Rihanna, the karma shake it.
Oh, Rihanna, the karma shake it. Shaka hala, the bush, yadibo, Rabu, send any bundle, head any
In the name of Jesus, connections to Pastor James, be connected. Stop him, Lord. What you have for us. Thank you for the blood of Jesus that avails for your people. Cover us right now, each and every one of us, Father. In Jesus' name, Jesus' name. Hallelujah, hallelujah.
Glory to God.
James is in, right? Great, great. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. But I can't see Pastor James though. Okay, okay. Yes, I see you now. Yes. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Whew. Whew. Praise God. Praise God. Well, tonight is our third night of teachings from Pastor James. And we have all been so inspired as we listen to his teachings the past few nights. And it certainly is a call from the Lord to level up, to go higher, to expand our vision, and to possess territories taken by our enemy. And I believe that for many of us, our eyes have been opened. And now we simply can't go back to where we were. We just have to move on and move up. And I trust this will be a commitment we make for ourselves individually as well as corporately. And just to introduce Pastor James, you would have heard that Pastor James was an ex-Satanist for many years and have gone through unbelievable experiences. But having been delivered from them, he now ministers with great authority and a special grace in the area of deliverance and healing. So he shares revelations and insights which, if we are able to catch, actually opens doors for us. So do listen carefully. Pastor James, although not pastoring now, dedicates his time to raising and training up watchmen, gatekeepers, intercessors. So let us give him a truly warm Malaysian welcome. Over to you, Pastor James.
Thank you so much. Can I go on without my video?
Yes, you may. Yes, because otherwise that will interfere, right? Because, yes.
No need to use video, Pastor.
Been having interference.
Yes. It's okay.
I can go ahead without a video.
Yes.
Welcome, everyone. We thank the Lord for this moment. And also, as we had on the first day, I had something that really challenged me when the Lord was telling us, remain focused. You know, it was just a simple statement, but from the first step now, it has kept ringing in my mind, even my prayer, even in where I'm doing the convocation, the consecration camp here. The word I'm getting every day, remain focused. So the enemy may want to bring distractions and confusion, but the Lord is telling us, remain focus. We are looking at possessing the gates.
Amen.
Just to remind ourselves that on Monday, as we were sharing, I felt this like an urgent call. The Lord challenging us to possess the gates. To possess, meaning we have not been possessing the gates. Meaning there has been something that has been at the gates. And he wants us to dislodge and possess. And we realized that we began the journey. We're talking about repairing the breaches, what we looked at in that scripture, the repair of breaches, and also raising foundations of many generations.
Cut off again.
There is a call. The Lord is calling us to return to truth. In the coming days, there will be, actually not in the coming days, but I say in the days we are in, there is deception. There is falsehood at the gates. There is the lies, and people have believed the lies. The enemy has been, there has been this war, I call it the information war, the information era we are in, where people can access all kind of knowledge and information, which is not truth. And then the church that is supposed to bring truth, sometimes we've been not acting the way we should act on the gates. For example, the gates of our education in our schools, the gates of the family, in our homes. Do we bring truth? The challenge is truth. Scripture is a call for intercession. When you look at Isaiah chapter 59, and we're going to have it on our screens, we know we can read it, and then you find where they says, we'll start from verse 1, and we shall read, we shall go up to where I say stop there. Okay, Isaiah chapter 51. Behold, the Lord's hand is not shortened. Isaiah 59, please, not 51. Isaiah 5:9. Behold, the Lord's hand is not shortened, that it cannot save. Nor is ear dull that cannot hear. But your iniquities have made a separation between you and your God, and your sins have hidden his face from you so that he does not hear. For your hands are defiled with blood and your fingers with iniquity. Your lips have spoken lies. Someone said, look, that your tongue muttered wickedness. No one enters justly. And no one goes to law honestly. They rely on empty pleas. They speak lies. They conceive mischief and give birth to iniquity. They hatch other eggs. They weave. They weave the spider's web. He who eats their eggs dies. And from one that is crushed, a viper is hatched. Their webs will not serve as clothing. Men will not cover themselves with what they make. Their works are works of iniquity. Their deeds of violence are in their hands. Their feet run to evil. They are swift to shed innocent blood. Their thoughts are thoughts of iniquity. Disorder and destruction are in their highway. The way of peace they do not know. There is no justice in their path. They have made their roads crooked. No one treads on them, knows peace. Therefore, justice is far from us, and righteousness does not overtake us. We hope for light and behold darkness, and for brightness, but we walk in gloom. We grope for the wall like the blind. We grope like those who have no eyes. We stumble at noon as in the twilight. Among those in full vigor, we are like dead men. We all grow like bears. We mourn and mourn like doves. We hope for justice, but there's none. For salvation, but it's far from us. For our transgressions are multiplied before you, and our sins testify against us. For our transgressions are with us, and we know our iniquities. Transgressing and denying the Lord. Transgressing and denying the Lord, and turning back from following our God. Speaking oppression and revolt, conceiving and uttering from the heart lying words. From the heart lying words. Now, because of the lying hearts, from the heart we have lying words. The next verse says, justice is turned back and righteousness stands far away, for truth has stumbled in the public squares, and uprightness cannot enter. Please note that word. Uprightness cannot enter. Why? Look at that. Upright. Please mark that word and highlight it. Uprightness cannot enter. Cannot enter. Why? Truth is lacking, and he who departs from evil makes himself a prey. Now look at the next verse. The Lord saw it, and it displeased him that there was no justice. He saw that there was no man, and wondered that there was no one to intercede. There was no one to intercede. Why? Uprightness cannot enter. Truth is lacking, and the Lord saw it. Please note and highlight that. The Lord wondered that there was no one to intercede. The Lord saw it, and it displeased him. What displeased the Lord was what? That there was no one to intercede. So uprightness, what is uprightness? I believe uprightness is the purposes of God. It is justice. It's prosperity. It's holiness, the fear of God. Love, godliness. Here is something I want to say today. If we embrace truth, we shall see godliness, the fear of God, back in our homes, in our schools, and then our nation. Then remember, I said this and we agreed together that this is what we are pursuing, that Malaysia will be the dwelling place of the Lord. The land of the glory of God. We are going to pursue it in prayer. And he's saying, look, there is uprightness cannot enter unless you embrace truth. You bring in truth. You welcome truth, which is the wisdom of God. The ways of God, which is godliness. Godliness returning. It's my prayer today as we possess the gifts this year. To pursue godliness, to call the nation, to call the church, the intercessors, to investigate our cities and bring cases before the Lord, calling for justice, calling for uprightness. And this is very important. Where there are lies, where there's deception, there's something that happens. Blindness. Where there's no truth, there is spiritual blindness. The prophets are blinded. The church is blinded. And this is what the Lord is calling us right now. What are the things that have become veils, like scales on our eyes, that we cannot see. What are the lies? Is it the lust of the eyes? Is it the desire for wealth? Is it the lust for fame? What is that thing at a personal level? What is that lie that I have compromised with that has blinded me? What is the lie that has blinded us? It's time to ask the Lord to search, because that lie has gone deep, 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 deep in the heart. In the heart. The idol in the heart. And that lie, which I need to ask the Lord, where is the lie? What is that? You know, when the Bible says conceiving and uttering from the heart lying words. So we conceive and speak from our hearts, but we are now bring forth lying words. Lying words. And today, as watchmen, as intercessors, as prayer warriors who desire to see the glory of God, we must come face to face with truth. And let the Lord, the Spirit of truth, convict us of a lie. Friends, I have seen ministries, I've seen men of God and women of God under a lie, and they bring many lives in destruction because there is a lie. A lying spirit comes, but not only a lying spirit. The men and the women of God begin to teach a lie because they have thrown away truth. Here is the issue. We have thrown away truth from our marriages. Truth is not in our marriages. Truth is not in our businesses. And that's what we see in the nation is what is in the church. And the Lord looked and said, but there is no, truth is lacking. He said, truth is lacking. And I'm emphasizing truth as a foundation. I believe one of the foundation stones we need now is the stone of truth to become the cornerstone of our lives. As a nation, we want to see the Lord. That you desire truth in the inner parts. You desire truth. It's my cry today. We, God is calling to stand on the gates, to embrace truth and reject falsehood and lies, especially the issue of the heart. And this brings me to an important aspect. One aspect of gates. Before you look at the physical gates, administrative gates, spiritual gates, prophetic gates, how about what this gate, which is mentioned here, the gate of the heart. Possess the heart, the gate of the heart. And what is in the gate of the heart? Idols. Idols in the heart. That we want to host the Lord. He's coming in the land. But we who are standing before the Lord to possess the gate, are we having clean hands? Are we not having idols? What is that one idol that is a lie that must be dethroned today? In fact, 2024, as we call on the name of the Lord, as we come together, may the Lord expose to us the idols. Which idol in the heart? Because the heart is a gate. The heart of a man and then the heart of a nation. Blessed are the pure in heart, for they shall see God. Praise the Lord. We know that Matthew chapter 5. Blessed are the pure in heart, for they shall see the Lord. Blessed are the pure in heart, for they shall see the Lord. Matthew 5, 8. The purity. I want to see the Lord. Because one of the ways that I'm seeing as intercessors, I've been in this ministry of training intercessors myself. I believe God called, people call me apostle, but I think others call me pastor. But one thing I'm sure of, God put this upon me to be an intercessor, which I know I believe everyone, every believer should be. And one thing I've observed as an intercessor, my strength is in my sight. My ability to see the Lord, to see the unseen. Because if I can see the unseen, then I can do the impossible. My strength as an intercessor is in sight. Am I able to see the Lord? Am I able to see the unseen realm? In other words, I operate in visions. You operate in visions. By the way, you cannot possess without vision. You cannot possess, I cannot possess the gates without visions, without my vision, without seeing the Lord, without interacting with the unseen realm through visions, through dreams, through prophetic insights, through revelation. But all these, there's a gate that the enemy possessed or occupied. It's the gate of the heart. Blessed are the pure in heart, for they shall see God. You know, we have many of us, many people today who want to see the Lord, but their hearts are hardened. Their hearts, our hearts are full of idols. We have let the world, sometimes we've compromised and we sold our hearts. How is our, I'm asking myself, how is my heart? I want to see the Lord in the land. He's calling you, he's calling us to the issue of the heart. And as we watch, we possess the gates. There is something I want us to also consider. Why are our hearts not pure? Why are our hearts hardened? Why are our hearts full of bring forth lying words? Are we wicked? Are we evil? Are we bad? Here is something I want to consider today as we possess the gates. The wounded hearts. Woundedness. Because when there is a wound in someone's life, and that wound is not dealt with, we create walls to protect ourselves from, so that we cannot be wounded, to protect our wounds. And those walls become strongholds that they are protecting us, but also they are keeping the Lord away from us. Because we hide our hearts. We hide in, I know what things we are hiding in. And those walls must fall for the Lord to come in our hearts and bring healing, then the heart will be pure. I am praying for the healing of the heart. I'm praying for the healing of the hearts of the mothers in the land, the fathers in the land, the sons in the land, the gatekeepers, the wounded intercessors, the wounded prayer warriors, woundedness. It's the wounds in the hearts of the intercessors because of rejection, because of abandonment, because of abuse, spiritual abuse. There's an issue of spiritual abuse, manipulation, witchcraft that has brought woundedness in the church, in the intercessor. And as we possess the gates today, I'm asking the Lord for the healing of a wounded intercessor, the wounded hearts, the crushed hearts, the broken hearts. Because as we go through the healing, there's going to be a cleansing in the coming days, removing the filthiness of the heart that you can see God. My brother, my sister, on this night, I'm praying for the healing of the wounded hearts. The wounded watchmen. Because being a watchman, being a gatekeeper, you use your sight, but also you a warrior, some of us. But if I am a wounded warrior, I'm wounded at the gates, then I cannot fight. Though I have the weapons, though I have the assignment, though I have the mandate, wounded. But today is the day the Lord has made to heal our hearts, that the glory of the Lord come upon us and upon the nation. You know, as I'm talking about the lie, sometimes is that because of woundedness, there are some things we believed, we built around ourselves, and they are lies, deception, an attitude, a belief that is a lie. I pray in the name of Jesus, as we possess the gates, you know, that let there be healing. And someone may say, James, teach us about spiritual fear, how to fight at the gates, what to fight. That is not what is needed now. It will not help to tell you what to fight, how to fight, and when you are not able to fight. The Lord has been dealing with me in a few years ago, saying you cannot fight when you're not healed. A wounded soldier, a wounded fighter, is not only a danger to himself, but a danger to the army he's fighting with. If you are in an army, you are in a church, you're in a group, and you're wounded, you're a danger to yourself, but you're a danger to your teammates, the people you're fighting, the team you're going together with. In fact, it's time now, as we prepare for the coming glory in the land, the Lord to dwell in the land, to seek the healing of the hearts, to go to the place of healing, to call on the Lord to heal the wounded hearts, the wounded intercessors. We all know, many of us, I know we've been part of the church for many years. We know the pain, the wounds of many intercessors, prayer warriors. We know that. We know there are many that have given up or are giving up. You know, there are many that feel abused. We know there are many that cannot come to the altar again. We know there are many that left our fellowships wounded. They left our churches wounded. They left our prayer groups wounded. They are grieving, they are mourning, and some of them are cursing. How do we bring them back? How do we pray for them? Because they need to return. They have a role to play in the coming move of God, but they are wounded. They can't even come in our meetings. Even us who are watching right now, the years of many have been meeting intercessors, and this is what I hear. I can't go to church again. I'm doing my intercession at home. I can't join them. They betrayed me. They abused me. This happened. And the Lord is asking us watching today, where is your brother? Where is the fellow watchman? I want to give you the nation, but where is your brother? Because you are your brother's keeper. What happened to his heart? What happened to your heart? And if you, what are the ways the enemy will disqualify us and put spells upon us is through offense, taking offense, being not letting the Lord heal the wound and thinking that you are healed, and you go on in denial when you about to have God is about to trust you with something. The enemy will bring an offense, and through that offense you open up to his arrows. Offense. Let me share with you this story. If you've read my book, Delivered from Deep Darkness, you find the story I'm going to say. If you've listened to my testimony, you'll find this story. Before I came to Christ, you all know, been told that I was a guardian master of Satanism in Africa, a guardian master in Africa. And one day in the year 2019, I was called to go and attend a conference in Seychelles Islands, a city called Victoria. And it was a conference of almost more than thousands of devil worshippers, witches, business director, executives, managers, celebrities, all those that believe in the occult, in the realm of Satan, that gathered in this conference. And in the conference was about highways. And there was a discussion that one of the major highways, that's the highway of the Nile, that goes through from Uganda, it goes to Egypt, Sudan, Egypt, Damascus to Jerusalem. And they said that highway is closed. We cannot access it. And this in this conference, the saying was that if we cannot access that highway, and we go into the year 2000, and in the year 2000, it means we will not be operating according to their systems. So in this discussion, in this meeting, they were saying they have failed to take over that highway because, now these are thousands and high-level witches, certain spar in Seychelles Islands. They say because there is a group of 20 women and one man in a little church that have taken over the territory. Now, these were 20 illiterate women who were not known anywhere. Even I didn't know them. And these women were in Uganda, illiterate women. And I was told in this meeting that these women were doing a prayer that they had sealed off this territory of these nations. And what they were doing was going to cause the kingdom of Satan, our systems, not to operate in that region and other regions for 70 years. And these women were praying a prayer 6 hours every day. And they had said they're going to pray for 90 days. And I could see the fear, the confusion in this meeting where we were. And I was told, return to Uganda, find a way of going interfering with those women. Because if you don't, and they finish their 90 days of prayer and fasting as they do, we will not be able to operate anywhere. So they would be taking over territory. And in the report, this is what they said to me, that they have investigated 7,000 pastors and churches that had backslidden, that we had defeated, were suddenly revived and coming back to fire because of the prayers that were coming from these 20 women. So the 20 women were reviving 7,000 pastors and churches. Now, I want to say this. Those in the kingdom of darkness, well, is our enemy, Satan. They know the power of prayer. They know. I knew the power of prayer. I knew what prayer can do before I came to Christ. It's unfortunate that today the believers, the church, do not understand, do not appreciate the power of prayer. They take prayer casually, not knowing nothing happens in the spirit realm without prayer, if you're a Christian. And in the kingdom of darkness, the kingdom of darkness can only survive where there is no prayer. Please note that. I was in the kingdom of darkness. I was serving Satan. I was a guardian master. I'd been trained in Europe. I'd been all this. The one thing I knew, the kingdom, the work Satan and his demons and his spirits and witches and wizards can only work where there's no prayer. In any territory where there's a prayer, witches cannot work, and they have to interfere with prayer. They have to interfere with effective praying. They have to make the church become a preaching church, not a praying church. The moment the volume of prayer goes down, evil increases. And you must know this. If prayer, the volume goes down, evil increases. If prayer, the volume of prayer increases, evil disappears. And That's why I commit myself to prayer. That's why I pray long hours. That's why I love prayer. I never give up in prayer. Because before I came to the Lord, I came to Christ, I knew the power of prayer. I knew that we those who were in darkness, those who were serving Satan, they were only surviving and flourishing because there was no prayer. And when there's prayer, prayer that takes over territories, they cannot. So I was told to come and interfere with their prayers. But I was warned that if I attack these people, I'll either die or get converted. And one of them happened. I came to attack that group. And after that, I ended up getting converted later. Because the fact that I tried to attack them, their power still also converted me, though not through them. And this is what happened, what I'm bringing to you. When I gathered my team to go and see how we can interfere with their prayers, the girl I sent in this meeting, because everyone in the meeting, those women, we had gathered information about their bloodlines, about their families, each one of them almost 10 generations back. So we could tell the pattern in their lives. The leader, one of the leaders, the pastor, and there was this woman who was like a co-leader. She had a gift of sight. She was a seer. And we had identified that she had an issue with her dead mother. She had not dealt with that woundedness. So when this girl came to interview their prayer, she knew where to hit. So she came to the pastor. She was introducing herself to the pastor. And the woman saw in the spirit and came and told the pastor, "That person I have seen is not of God." And this girl spoke to her and said, "But you speak like your mother." Oh, she got offended. She cast, she spoke a negative word towards her. And the moment she did that, demons put a spell on her. And from that time, the group got confused. Within 21 days, they were scattered. The covenant broke. The revival stopped. They were spearheading a revival. But because of one member who had a wound in the heart, now through offense, confusion came in the meeting, and that scattered them. And I learned that lesson. And I'm saying to us right now, as we watch the gates, let's look at our hearts and ask ourselves, is there something I need to let go that God will heal me and take away offense? What are the things that have offended you? Are you watching with offense? Have you been offended? Here is what God is calling you today. Alistair, to come to the altar for healing this moment as we possess the gate, especially the heart. Because with wounded hearts, there can't be the all. And my prayer for you is to be healed, to ask the Lord to heal you and take away offense, and also gather and intercede for the brothers and sisters that have been wounded. Because what has wounded them is iniquity. It is the thing that corrupted them, the lies, the deception. And that because of that, many have left their posts because they are wounded. Let's take a moment, each one of us right now. It's a moment of seeking healing right now. And that's what the Lord put upon me today. And said, let the hearts be healed. Then the lies will disappear. The idols will go away. The heart will be pure. They will see me and they will know what to do as they possess the gates. I want us to take a moment right now in prayer, in worship, seeking God for healing, presenting our hearts, asking God to heal us, to heal the hearts that we may embrace truth, because truth is a sword in the name of Jesus. Come, Lord Jesus. I want to pray that right now there will be healing and cleansing. Every pain, every fear will be cast out in the name of Jesus. And every idol will be dethroned. The idols of iniquity, the fears, the memories of pain, the rejection, the betrayals, the lies, be removed right now from our lives. In the name of Jesus, Father God, many of us that have been offended for years, I speak in the name of Jesus, the healing power of Jesus Christ. Karababakoshe. I speak healing to that woman. I speak healing to that mother who was wounded, offended, rejected, abandoned. Many that are going through betrayal right now. Childhood abuse, those that are abused in church, the pain in the heart, the woundedness, the lies. In the name of Jesus, I rebuke the tormentor. I rebuke the spirit that has tormented you. I rebuke the power that has tormented your life, that tormented your mother, and passed the abuse unto you, and passed the bitterness. In the name of Jesus Christ, Son of the living God, my Father and my God, I come to you today seeking the healing of my brothers and sisters, healing the soul, healing the hearts, healing the minds, healing them right now, that they may see you, Lord God Almighty. For truth to dwell in us, there must be healing. Oh, rakata broshi katabra. Zakata de katabrosia. Masa katabroko shikedea. Masala bababakoshi katabro. Le sikitikiri bababakoshia. Masa katabroko shiketa, brother. Rekata broshi nedidia. Masiketa la bababakosha la babaya. The healing balm, the healing water, the stream of living water flow right now in this gathering, and let the hearts be healed. Let the souls be healed. The stronghold will break right now. The woundedness will be taken away. The shame will be removed today in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Let's lift our voices and let's continue to pray, because right now the Lord heals you in the name of Jesus.
Lord, I worship you. I worship you. Lord, I worship you. I worship you, for your name is holy, holy, Lord. He was shining in the middle of the little bush animal. I enter the Holy of Holies. I enter through the blood of the Lamb. I enter to worship you only. I enter to honor I am. Lord, I worship you. I worship you. Lord, I worship you. I worship you. Oh, your name is holy, holy, Lord. Your name is holy. Your name is holy. Oh, shine more than
Vidi Boshna in the end of the devil. See Elebo in the end of the devil. Shandedibu. Vielebo Shiniando. Rotten Hunabo Shayelebo. Vini and Elebo Shanimoka Hatahasi. Vini Elebo. Lord, I worship you. I worship you. Lord, I worship you. Restore to us, Lord, a clean heart, a clean spirit, Lord. Shini mandala boshaya, shanda hede ke hindi yendele bo. Shini ni mandala bo, shani mohonda na basaya. Rada bo shini yendele bo shata. Shandi hini yendele bo. Vini ni ando lola boshi e oh, Lord, I worship you. Lord, I worship you. Lord, I worship you. Come, Holy Spirit, God. Touch each and every one of us.
The Lord is ministering to each and every heart, even as we were worshiping. But I just wonder if Pastor James would want to continue this ministering. Pastor James? Pastor James?
James has asked for me because he has to do something.
So shall we'll continue to just yes. we're just wondering if there's anything you want to continue to minister to us.
This is, I know that was enough, but I just want to declare the blessing of the Lord for healing.
Right.
I asked today because I felt we need to go more in worship in the next few minutes and let the Lord minister to us. As we watched, it was also going through my worship because I believe I also need the healing. I realized there was, as we worshiped, there was something the Lord was pointing at me and said, deal with that if you are to watch the gates, if you are to possess the gates. So I think every one of us should now go through the same and let the Lord minister to us right now.
Amen.
Amen. God bless.
Amen. Thank you, Pastor James. So, Pastor Nixon, we just carry on in worshiping the Lord, because the Lord will continue to minister even in realms that we don't know, we are not aware of. Hallelujah. We'll just worship for a short while, another 2-3 minutes or 5 minutes. Yeah?
Lord, I worship you. I worship you. Lord, I worship you. I worship you. For your name is holy, holy, Lord. Shahele boshande hidiya lodo boshata heya. Oh, dear Jesus, heal every wounded heart. Lord, I worship you. I worship you, Lord. I worship you.
Thank you, Lord. Thank you.
I worship you, for your name is holy.
This is what we're going to do next. We're still going to listen to Pastor James, but it will be via an audio. Some of you would have heard it this morning. Can I get Max? Can you just play the audio for me? Because in this audio, Pastor James is also ministering. Sorry. I wasn't aware that I was muted. Sorry. Okay. This is what we're going to do. We're going to listen. We're going to allow Pastor James to minister to us this time through the audio that I played this morning at the prayer altar. because in this audio he continues to minister as well, and also at the same time speak briefly about the destiny of Malaysia as an altar nation.
Give us the good desires that have come from you. Amen. Amen. And what that desire in you, it didn't come even from you. It's the Lord who started it. You have a unique interest in something. Are you getting me? We desire the prayer altar. And now I know the destiny of Malaysia.
Amen.
Malaysia is an altar nation.
Hallelujah.
It's the altar.
Amen.
The altar nation. The fire on the altar from Malaysia.
Yes, Lord.
That will revive nations.
Amen.
That will awaken nations.
Amen.
I know now Malaysia is an altar nation. This is the destiny of Malaysia.
Hallelujah.
To be an altar nation.
Hallelujah.
Now I know this is a fire nation.
Amen.
Now we know the destiny of this nation.
Amen.
Is to bring the fire.
Amen.
Is to bring what?
Fire.
Is to bring the fire, even the fire of democracy. Are you getting me?
Amen.
Even the fire of good governance.
Amen.
Even the fire of transformation.
Amen.
We are the altar of the nations.
Amen.
Amen. Uganda, we know our destiny. We are midwives. We are midwife nation. Are you getting me? Singapore, the Antioch nation. Malaysia, the fire altar nation. Now we understand the nations. So when I'm praying for Singapore, I know Uganda. Now, today, I know Malaysia. Malaysia is supposed to get the fire and send it to the nations. It's the altar nation. It's the nation of the altar. Now I know that, and that's what we're going to pursue. Do you desire it?
Yes.
Do you desire it?
Yes.
This is the destiny of Malaysia.
Hallelujah.
To be the altar of the fire of the Lord to the nations. Hear me? This is the destiny of Malaysia.
Hallelujah.
To be the altar nations, to send the fire to the nations.
Amen.
Now we know that we are the altar. Are you getting me?
Yes.
We know that there are nations that are gates, but Malaysia, we know is the whole nation where the fire starts.
Amen.
And spread to the nations. We are the fire nations.
Amen.
We are the fire nation. The altar here is for reviving nations.
Yeah.
Is to rekindle other nations. In fact, God is sending all of you to nations to rekindle them now.
Amen.
Because you are the altar. The other one is the Antioch, but you are the altar. Are you getting what I'm talking about? The fire on this nation, and the entire nation will become an altar. Altars will come from different places, and the entire nation is covered in the fire. And then this fire will spread to different parts of the world.
Hallelujah.
The places you will go to that have been called, because you've gone there, the fire will start.
Amen.
You'll go to those nations and there will be fire.
Amen.
There will be fire of prayer.
Amen.
Fire of prayer.
Amen.
The message of this nation is the prayer altar message. God is telling you, disciple nations in the prayer altar.
Amen.
Disciple other nations in the prayer altar.
Amen.
Hear me, Malaysia. Disciple other nations in the prayer altar. Go and teach them to raise altars, because you are the altar nation. You are the fire to those nations. God is calling you to disciple those nations to raise the altar of the Lord. To learn from you that you can raise an altar and there's change, there's transformation. You get a good government, you get good people, and there'll be transformation. And I'm telling you, because of this call, many will come to this nation to learn principles of revival.
Amen. Hallelujah.
I wish you believed what I say.
Amen.
Father, we receive that fire.
Yes, Lord. Father,
and today, we accept,
yes, Lord,
to be the altar nation.
Amen, Father,
that sent the fire.
Yes, Lord, Father, Lord.
Somebody need to worship the Lord. Yes, Lord. Today, we accept,
to
be the altar nation that sent the fire. Today we accept that, we desire it, we see it, we walk in it, we accept it, we operate in it, because we are the nation you have chosen as the altar of the end time revival. We are the people, we are the people. Oh, hallelujah, 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 we desire it. We love it. We accept it. We accept it. We desire it. We accept it. We love it. We accept it. To be the altar nation. A nation that is the altar of the Lord who answers with fire. Just lift your hands. Listen, put your hands down. Now I know what you've been doing since 2012. You've been doing what Elijah did to repair the altar. And then build the altar. And what happened after the altar being built? What came down? After the altar, fire came down. So I know many leaders, pastors, our national leaders, you've been repairing the altar. You've been building it. And now the fire is coming. There was a lot of prayer and say, oh, we prayed a lot and we didn't see the answer. It was still repairing the altar. Now came this time, more prayer, more consecration, more reading the Bible. And now the altar is built and the fire is coming down. And the fire is coming now on the altar. Because now the Lord is saying, I have an altar nation. I have a nation I can call my altar. That nation is Malaysia. We accept that calling. We accept that anointing. We accept the fire. Can you prophesy that? Thank you.
needs you. I desire you. And you, Lord, are Lord. And you, we desire the nation. As a nation, we desire. It's you. It's you, Lord. It's you. It's you, Yahweh. Yahweh.
Like to pass this time over to Pastor Lee Chu.
Amen. You know, brothers and sisters, I don't know about you, but it's been 4 days, 4 nights of tremendous God speaking to us. And I feel that it's so clear. First, Bishop Ong really shared about possessing the gates, the seven gates. And he shared that it really starts with walking in covenant. So brothers and sisters, the first thing I want to highlight is this. I'm going to try and highlight what God has said. The first is that let's make prayer a serious thing, not just a fly by night, not just a one-off. It's not about the teaching, it's the practice. And I've heard his testimony before, Pastor James, but I'm reminded and I'm stunned again that 20 women praying for 6 hours for 90 days can close down the spiritual highways from Uganda right through to Damascus and to Israel. Wow, 90 days. But I just felt the God's, that's why I'm reminded, and he said this, right? Pastor James said, wherever there is prayer, the demonic realm cannot operate. And really, it's about the prayer altars. It's not even just about prayers. That worship of him, it's the adoration, it's the word, it's the lifting of him, it's the presence of God, it's the covenant. And what more? Even the greater power will be the covenanting with him. And that's where I felt, I want to start off by saying, wow, do not despise that every morning, 6:30 to 9 to 8, there is prayer going on the whole of Malaysia through the Zoom. Do not despise Monday to Saturday. And then in your churches, you're lifting it. Do not despise that every week in your church, there's an altar. Do not despise that there's a noon altar going on. Do not despise even RTOD's altar going on. Do not despise it, because this is what sustains Malaysia. This is what has been sustaining Malaysia. But now, as the battle intensifies and as God tells us to possess the gates, yeah, I hear Pastor James saying, this is not just a theme that came to us. I also don't know why we came up with this theme, but the theme was just came very strong. And we just felt, we all agreed, yes, that's the theme for this year, possess the gates of our enemies. Actually, the whole bit is possess the gates of your enemies. Just felt that's the season we cannot. And then 2024 comes along and God begins to say, and what Pastor James say, right? He said that God, when he gave this theme, it is because your gates, you have not possessed it. So what we have done is sufficient only to maintain a certain amount of atmosphere. But we cannot just maintain an atmosphere. We must now possess the gates of the enemies. Why? Because it is going to, the battle is raging at the gates. In fact, Isaiah 28 says, we are meant to turn back the battle at the gate. I can't remember the exact verse, but Susie can post it on the site's chat. That's a verse given to MEFW right back in 2022, that God would teach us how to turn back the battle at the gates. And so now we are going to be ready for God to train us to turn back the battle at the gates. And so what has happened is that Pastor James has shown us that some clues to how to turn back the battle at the gates. The first is actually that agreement is essential and the dwelling presence of God is essential. If you want to turn back the battle at the gates, it is called God's presence. Wow. And this is what on the Malaysian firewall, For just for information for you, so that all of you may want to join and become more committed, and don't just do it fly by night and just do it once in the blue moon when you feel like it. It's not about convenience. We now need to move to commitment. No soldier wins a war just when it's convenient to them. We have to go to the next level, which is commitment. And commitment is not enough. It's covenant. Bishop said covenant. So if you join us, we're going to train you on covenant. We're going to train you on how to court the presence of God. That's what the training for the last 2023 for the boot camp of MUFW, for the Pastor Shane came all the way from New York for 2 weeks nonstop, morning, noon, night, to train us how to court the presence of God. And that is why we are very intense, because it makes a difference. It makes a difference. You know, either we possess the gates of our enemies or the enemies possess our gates. In fact, it's not just the gates of nation, the gates of our hearts. Offenses come. And do you know that I just learned one thing tonight? The heart is the gateway of life. And so when your heart is bitter, when your heart is offended, your heart is hurt, there's no life flowing in anymore. And when there's no life going in, then what is that? We are already a gateway. There's no life. How can God bring life to the world? How can God bring life to our families through us? How can God bring life to the church? That's why churches can be dry, because of offenses. So it's something we got to be careful about. And you know, and MUFW have been studying this whole topic of offenses for the last one month. And this is what the watchmen, when they register. So if you want to be registered as a watchman, begin to talk to your pastors, begin to talk to your prayer leaders, because that is how we are going to learn how to build an extensive network of prayer altars that draws in and courts the presence of God. And we are going to, the agreement is not, it's the power, right? The agreement is that Malaysia becomes the dwelling place of God. Malaysia, the presence of God will dwell in Malaysia, and the fire from heaven will come, like just like Elijah. And that is how the demonic realm moves out. And of course, last night is all about learning even so the truth that's needed. So there's so much to learn about prayer. Now, this is what we are going to do. We are going to be posting all these videos up on the MUFW website. So once more, I'm going to ask Mimi to post the MUFW website. And I'm going to encourage you, if you have come in as a church group, if you have come in as two or three people gather regularly to pray, begin to listen to it again. Join our early morning watches. Join our 24 hours in February. There'll be another one of 24 hours. Join it. And as you join, you learn. Then as you join, you learn. Then speak to your pastor. Can you join the MUFW watchman? And if you want to, you contact any of us, all right? Contact any of us, and we look for your facilitator to guide you, because really it's about setting up a network of prayer altars that draws in the presence of God, that will allow God's fire to go up and the glory of God to rest in Malaysia. The verse given to us right at the beginning of Malaysia United Firewall is Zechariah 2:5, that there'll be a wall of fire around Jerusalem, and the glory of God will be in it, that God will be a wall of fire. So when we build a network of prayer altars, God will be a fire, wall of fire, and his glory will dwell therein. That is the prayer altar. So I want to encourage, as you know what? MUFW is not another organization in prayer, another network of prayer. I just want people to join. No, we're not interested. We are asking, it's a call of God. It is urgent. You heard Pastor James say, it's urgent. That's why God asked you to possess the gates of your enemy. It's urgent. Possess it with fire coming from the altar. Possess it. Then the enemy cannot go in. And even as you see all the chaos in the nation, I think it's because we are building the altar, okay? We're building the altar. Now, if you're in a local region, gather a few people, start building a physical altar in your church. If every one of us start building a physical altar, one Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, Saturday, every day it will be kept. It will be covered. Every day there will be an altar going up throughout Malaysia. Every language group, Bahasa Malaysia, Chinese, Tamil, every type of tongue. That is what God is asking from us. That's our aim. So God is asking, respond. When you hear, you respond to this call. And as you respond, the glory of God will come and rest in Malaysia. How exciting can that get? Now, I hope you're excited. Amen. I hope you're excited. Now, don't just go in this year, come out that year. Because you know what? We want you to respond. So the first way to respond is go and listen to it, go to the website. The second way to respond is you contact what your pastor and you said, I want to learn how to be a watchman on the wall. And somehow contact us, contact someone that you know in this amongst us, Pastor Theo, Pastor Nancy, if you're in Sarawak, Pastor Patricia, Pastor Connie, if you're from different states, if you're in the language groups, Tamil, you contact Pastor JD. If you're BM, you contact Pastor JJ, John Jonathan, or Pastor Andrew Jalong. If you are a Chinese, Pastor Jenny, or even Sarah. Sarah will contact out. You can also contact Pastor Daniel Tan from RTOD, and we will try and begin. The training starts in March. But more important than training is now activate it. Begin to say, I want to learn. Build your own personal prayer altar where the glory of God comes in. Amen. 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 Wow. I don't know about you, but I've been extremely blessed, and I hope you have been. And so why don't we just ask Pastor Nancy to close us for tonight's prayer. Pastor Nancy. Incidentally,
okay, let's pray.
In your families as well. We want to build altars in your workplace as well. So we're progressive. But first, your personal altar, okay? Yeah, Pastor Andrew is ready to build altars for his people. Yeah, Ruth Ratnam too. Okay, Nancy, close us in prayer.
Yes, amen. Thank you, Lord, for being with us tonight. Thank you for blessing us so richly through these few nights of teachings. We have been enriched and empowered. And Lord, may we have your wisdom to apply what we have learned to our lives, that we'll not be just hearers, but be doers of your word. We declare in Jesus' name that everyone here will be doers of your word and not hearers only. And we declare Malaysia will fulfill her destiny to be an altar nation to host God's presence. Hallelujah. We give you thanks. We give you praise in Jesus' name. Bless us now, Lord, as we leave this place. Amen. Amen. Amen.
Amen. Thank you, everyone.
Amen.
You have been amazing. 4 nights you have been here together with us. So we're going to continue to try and gather this, and we're going to even come alongside to even train more watchmen. Amen. So that excited, and we will build a highway of holiness. Amen.